Good evening, everybody, and welcome to Victory Talk. I'm Brandon Gaddis.
And I'm Larissa Gaddis. And we are so excited to be on with you tonight. Tonight, our session is going to be actually talking about anxiety.
Anxiety.
But before we jump into that, we want to start by thanking WYTV7 Christian Broadcast Network for allowing us this opportunity to be a part of this amazing network. We are so thrilled as a Victory team to be working and partnering with WYTV7.
Yes. Well, let's jump into it and let's start off with prayer and let's get started.
Okay.
Dear and Father, I just want to tell you, thank you, Lord God, for this opportunity to talk about a big issue like anxiety. Father, we pray that somebody would be reached by this session today, Lord God, and in your word, Lord God, that they would be used at this moment to know that, Lord God, you are the healer of all things. Father, we thank you. We praise your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
All right. So this is exciting right here, man. This will be coming from John chapter 14, verse 27. Just right there. I'm telling you, it's a good verse. We'll be reading from the New Living Translation version. So get ready for this one. All right. I am leaving you with a gift, peace of mind and heart. And the peace I give is a gift the world cannot give. So don't be troubled or afraid. Let's say that one more time. I am leaving you with a gift, peace of mind and heart. And the peace I give is a gift the world cannot give. So don't be afraid. Don't be troubled. Or afraid.
That's good.
That's good, isn't it, babe?
That's good.
That's a big thing that we go through in this time, and it's a serious issue. Anxiety,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah, anxiety is a very serious issue. As we were even just talking about this topic and preparing for it, I looked into some statistics just to kind of see, like, okay, what numbers are we talking about? How many people is this actually affecting? And I found out that it affects 40 million adults that are 18 or older.
Jesus.
And women actually suffer twice as much as men.
Wow.
And I was just like, wow, like that is powerful. When you think about the impact that anxious thoughts have on our everyday life, it is significant. It is significant. And so just kind of to get into the scripture.
Yeah.
Do you want to start?
Yeah. So it started off by saying, I'm leaving you with a gift, peace of mind and heart. That's Jesus telling his disciples that I'm leaving you with peace.
Yeah.
You don't have to suffer with what the world gives you. You don't have to worry about what others say. You don't have to worry about your circumstances. See, what God wants us to do, essentially, man, what he wants us to do is to give all of our burdens to him.
Yeah.
Right? Good. And so we can give everything to him, our mind, our heart, our marriage. We want to give that to him. Our child that's on the way, we want to give that to him. Our job, he wants us to give it to him. I think we carry so much of that weight. In finances, even family, give your family. Like, they put their pressure. Your family can be your worst critics at times. They can put so much pressure on you and say, you need to do this way and do that way, but they don't, and you're trying to fight to be this double person. Mm-hmm. Like, you're trying to be a person at this light, and then when you, at another place, you're just dealing with so much depression and anxiety.
Yeah.
But God, in that a long time, he wants to have you give him everything. Everything that you're going through, give everything. Things that happened to you in your past, give it to him. He said it in his word. He said, I will give you a peace of mind,
yeah,
and a heart.
Yeah.
He didn't say, I'm going to give you frustration and pain.
I think too, I'm so glad that 2 weeks ago we did our session on No More Fear.
Right.
Because I believe that anxiety is rooted in fear.
Come on, man. That's good.
I believe that anxiety is rooted in fear. It's the what if statements that take us down into this rabbit hole of trying to figure out, and because we cannot figure out, because we don't know the answer to the what ifs, it's this negative spiral that takes us into these anxious thoughts that literally trigger our body to have this anxious response. And so when he says that he's leaving us with a gift, peace of mind and heart, I just want to challenge you right now to ask yourself, how often are you really there? How often do you really have peace of mind? How often do you really have peace of mind? Because if you are not functioning in peace, you know, on a regular basis, check your thoughts. They could be taking you into this negative spiral of anxiety and you don't even realize it. Because I didn't think for a long time that I had anxiety. You know, and I still don't say that I have anxiety because I'm grateful that I believe God has given me the ability to recognize my thoughts and literally cut them off before I allow them to get so far negative. And I'm by nature just a very positive and optimistic person. But anxiety and anxious thoughts do come to my mind. The enemy will send, what if you were to run off the road? What if somebody was to slam into your car? What if, you know, all of these things that are actually rooted in fear, right? And if I allowed my mind to continue to, oh my gosh, what if that did happen? And would I live, you know, would my baby live? You know, that's how you get into these anxious thoughts. And that's what starts anxiety. These what if statements that are centered around fear of whatever it is. And typically it's an unknown.
And this guy used to tell me at my job, man, where I used to work about 3-4 years ago, he's like, man, stress kills. Stress kills you. And it really does. You will be living trying to please this world so much that it will kill you. You allow your job to kill you. You allow people's words to kill you. Because of all of that pain, that stress will kill you. I mean, baby, I don't know the real facts to it, but it's a lot of young people who are stressing out so bad that they're having heart attacks now. They're at an uncommon age. And I think what comes with heart attacks is because of stress, putting too much worry into your spirit. See, the enemy, he knows how to attack you. He knows the right things to do to try to get you to say, no, you can't. No, you can't do that. So you're not meeting up to their standards. See, that's a problem. That's what the enemy will try to get you to sucker in. Because you look up to somebody or you trust somebody's word so much. But what does God's word say? What does his word say to give you what you need to survive? To keep you from having anxiety, to keep you from having depression. What are you going to do with it? Are you going to trust God or are you going to trust yourself and your own instinct? See, that's where you fail right there. That's how that stress comes out on you. You got to remember that every time when God speaks to you, say, yes, I can do this. Yes, I can win. And I just watched a word from Michael Todd. And he said, use your weakness as your strength. Change that motive and use that weakness as your strength to help somebody else, which was your old weakness, to save them from what God has done for you in your life. And so that's why we have to really consider what God is saying all the time. And he also went down there, he said, in the peace.
Before you move on, just to piggyback off of that, using your strength as your weakness, just as your mind says to you, what if something negative were to happen? Using your weakness as your strength would be counteracting that thought with, but what if something positive were to happen, right? And so that's really how you combat allowing anxiety and negative thoughts to take over, by combating it with a positive and a hopeful outcome. So when the enemy comes at you with, you know, what if I don't pass this test? What if I don't meet up to their standards? You challenge that thought with, what if I do? What if I do pass this test? What if I do meet up to their standards? What if I do make it home safely? You know, that's really how you fight back against it. And that comes from grasping onto the hope, grasping onto the confidence in who we are in Christ.
That's good, babe. And I think if you change that if to I will, your confidence in God will increase. It will increase every time. I will. And see, that's that test that you have. God wants to know, how much do you love me when things may seem troubling? How much do you love me when I say, Lord, I know in your will that you will make this thing work. In your will, Father, I know that I will survive. In your will, oh God, I can get over this sickness. In your will, Father, you know the outcome of whoever's in the hospital bed. You know, Lord, I will not cast this worry. You know those type of things. I will win. Baby, remember when you're just motivating me, be like, baby, say, yeah, your I ams. I am great. I am a child of God. I am. I am victorious. I am. I am love. I am peace. Lord God, I thank you. And those are the things that we need to say so we can come out victorious and victory over our anxiety. Yeah. That's it. That's the word. Everybody that's on and that's hearing this and watching this, you have victory over your anxiety. Yeah. Right now, we claim that in the name of Jesus. And then it goes down right here. It says, and the peace I give is a gift the world cannot give.
Yeah.
So don't be troubled or afraid.
Yeah. That's so good. It always like amazes me how much there is packed in one scripture, you know? And when you really just like break it down and like look into this scripture, there's so much. The first thing is that we're given a gift, right? It's of no charge. It's free. So we're given this gift of peace at no charge. There's not a whole lot of things in life that we just get for free. And so we're given this gift for free. And that's such a blessing. But then we find out that it's given by God. So we know exactly who the giver of the gift is, right? So we have peace of mind and we have peace of heart, which is our spirit. Our spirit can be at peace because we've been given this gift.
Yeah.
And we don't have to be troubled. I mean, that's the reality of it. It says here, don't be troubled or afraid. So if you find yourself in a place where you're feeling troubled or afraid, know that you don't have to be. You don't have to be because of the gift that Christ has given us. And we don't have to be afraid. And so it's so good when you really start unpacking these scriptures to just really don't just skim past and read it really quickly. Actually break this down and make it personal. Make it personal to your life.
Yep. And it goes back to everybody that prayer matters. Prayer is always going to be the key to allowing God to come into you.
Mm-hmm.
Because he doesn't want us to carry the weight of frustration. He does not want us to carry the weight of depression. He does not want us to carry the weight of anxiety. What he wants us to do is to give it to him.
Yeah.
He just be like, Lord, here you go. I whatever I'm feeling like this, I know this not you, but I want to give it to you because I know that you can give me the peace that I need.
Yeah.
Give him your troubles, give him your fears, and he'll give you that peace.
Yep,
he'll give you that love. He'll give you that faith. And it feels so good when you give it to him, because in our human nature, we want to just do it on our, we want to do it on our own. Mm-hmm. We want to solve the problem on our own.
Yeah.
And once you feel that way, or trying to solve it on your own, reverse that and make God the answer to how you really feel, because you have feelings.
Yeah.
You can be hurt, but during those times, just give it to our Father. He's right there just waiting on us to be like, Lord, please take it.
Yeah.
I need you. What I need. I need this peace, Father, because I'm carrying too much weight. I'm worried about people around me, and I'm scared. It was just this week, how God just changed my motive when I just gave it to him. I was a little funk this week. You remember that, babe? I'm like, man, I don't even know how I'm feeling. I was carrying so much weight, didn't even know it. And I just started calling out those demons. I called out all those hurts. And I was just like, Lord, take it. Take it from me. I need you to take it from me so I cannot deal with this.
Yeah.
Have to worry about this. Because to be honest, we're breaking generational curses with this. And I know with some of y'all that's watching this that's dealt with generational curses that your parents worried, you're worrying, that your grandparents worried, they suffered with anxiety, and they may not shown it. But you know deep inside that you need help and you need God to come through.
Yeah.
Come through, Lord.
Yeah.
That's it. Let's come
through.
There
is an answer.
It is.
There is an answer to fear. There is an answer to anxiety. And it's rooted in the word. The answer to anxiety and the answer to fear is peace. It's the peace that he has given us. It's the peace that he's given us freely, a free gift. And so we challenge you on tonight to just really reflect on your own life, reflect on your own thoughts. I think that, you know, sometimes we don't even really think about our thoughts. We just think them, right?
Yeah.
And so when you become more conscious, you can become more conscious about what you're thinking and flag the thoughts that are negative and then ask yourself, okay, is this negative thought really making me better or worse?
Mm.
When you determine that it's making me worse, then challenge that thought every time it arises with a positive. Challenge it with the word of God that says, God gave me peace of mind and heart.
Yeah.
God gave me hope. He gives me joy. He gives me, he protects me. He loves me. Challenge those thoughts today. And so we pray that this lesson and this session has been beneficial. And just to recap our scripture, babe, you should recap our scripture.
Yeah, our scripture again, guys, came from, and ladies, came from John chapter 14, verse 27. And it states, I am leaving you with a gift, peace of mind and heart. And the peace I give is a gift the world cannot give. So don't be troubled or afraid. That was our subject today. And it speaks so much of what God can do.
Yeah.
We have victory over anxiety.
We do.
We have victory over that.
We do.
We have to be a team. We have to collectively surround ourselves with people, too, who can encourage you to help you and be like, hey, let's pray.
Yeah.
Hey, let's get in the word. What does the word say? And it community matters, right?
And even to call it out, you know. We start getting into this negative spiral of complaining or it's not going to work or you got to have somebody in your life that will shut that thing down.
Come on.
Wait a minute.
Wait a minute.
We're not doing that. We're not doing that. That's not what we're going
to
do.
Right. We're not speaking death to that.
Right. We're going to speak life to this situation.
Yeah.
We're going to believe that it's going to, all things are going to work together for the good of those who love you, who love God and are called according to his purpose. That's what we're going to believe.
Yeah, that's what we're going to believe. And we believe that. And we know that God is going to come through for us. And for you, those who are watching and listening, that God going to come, he is going to come through.
Yeah.
Call out your pain, even in your thoughts. If you see some crazy stuff in your mind that you know ain't aligned with God, You make sure that you go to God and be like, Lord, why is these thoughts coming up?
Check that thought.
I'm telling you, it starts right there in your mind. Don't let that thing go into your heart and come into your flesh and give it all to God. Because what God needs you to do, he wants you to see what the troubles can happen if you don't choose him. So it's not necessarily negative thoughts. It's probably God warning you to keep you from those troubles. So trust him with those thoughts. Give it to him. He has you. He's got you. He's not going to leave you like stranded. He's a God that will never leave you nor forsaken you. He's a light in the dark tunnel. He's right there. He's like, man, I need you to stay focused on me. Follow the light. Follow the light.
Amen.
Amen. This is beautiful. This is a beautiful lesson, baby.
Yeah.
I'm truly excited for those who tuned in today. And watch this today, because I pray that you're blessed by this, because God, he's so awesome, man. Y'all are talking about a person who dealt with a lot of anxiety. Trust me, I had a problem. If I didn't please the world, I was a failure. And God said, you got your life twisted, brother. You need to choose me instead of trying to please this world. Man, they can't do nothing for you. What I can do. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Because I know God can do it. He strengthens me through Christ who strengthens me. not through social media that strengthens me, mm-hmm. not through my mom and daddy that strengthens me, mm-hmm. not through my boss who strengthens me, through Christ who strengthens me. So let's pray, babe, and because this was a beautiful setting. And again, we have what? Victory, all right, over anxiety. Let's go on and pray. Dear the Father, I just want to tell you thank you for those who watched, who tuned in here on with Victory Team, Victory Talk today, Lord God, on victory over anxiety. Father, we thank you right now, Lord God, for your power, your everlasting power. Those who are dealing with anxiety and depression right now, Lord God, that you will remove that right now in the name of Jesus. We pray for those who are dealing with their job, dealing with their family issues, holding so much pressure on them, the Lord God, that the weight is so much on them, they bear it to the ground, Lord God. We pray, Lord God, that you will take off that weight, Lord God, that they will stand up strong in the name of Jesus. Lord God, that they will win like David beat Goliath, Lord God, that those Goliaths will be strung down with that rock, Lord God. We thank you right now in the name of Jesus that we have the victory, Father, that we will follow you, Lord God, just like Paul did, Lord God, when he surrendered his life to Christ, Father. We thank you right now, Lord God, for your power. Father, we thank you because your power is everlasting. Your power is infinite. Lord God, we thank you right now, Lord God, that nobody will have those burdens anymore, Lord God, that they will continue to praise your name, Lord God, even when those thoughts come back, those negative thoughts, those anxiety type of thoughts, Lord God, will be removed in the name of Jesus. Lord God, we thank you right now, Lord God, that sickness will be healed, Lord God. We thank you that families will be healed in the name of Jesus. Relationships will be healed, Lord God. Their workplace will be healed in the name of Jesus. They will be the light and they will be an example for you in Jesus' name. Father, we thank you so much for your power. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen.
Bees up. Amen, amen, yeah. Amen. Thank you guys so much for tuning in with us again for our session on tonight, Victory Over Anxiety.
Yes.
We just want to remind you that you can purchase our t-shirt, our crew necks, at victorybrandstore.com.
Yeah, Victory Brand Store.
Yes. You can find us on Facebook and on Instagram, Victory Team Movement, as well as on WYTV7.
Yes.
Talking to us there sometimes. Yeah. Christian Broadcast Network, we want to thank you guys for just tuning in with us on this amazing network. And I just want to remind you that WYTV7 is a nonprofit organization and they do function off of your donations. And so go and give and plant a seed that decrees and declares that you have victory over anxiety. If you've been blessed by this on tonight, go and put your faith on your healing over your mind, healing over your thoughts, okay? And so we love you so much. And we look forward to seeing you again next week.
Amen. Y'all have a good one. Have a good evening. And we'll see y'all next week. V's up.
Thank you so much for watching and listening. We are so excited to have you as a part of the WYTV7 community. If you do not know the God that we often refer to in the Bible that we reference here on this network, we want to give you an opportunity right now through the call to salvation. All it takes is openly declaring that Jesus is Lord and that you believe God raised him from the dead in your heart and you're saved. It's just that simple. And so if you've prayed that prayer today, we want to welcome you to the family of believers. And if you need prayer or any kind of resource that we can help provide and assist you with on this new journey that you're embarking upon, contact us at wytv7.org and we'll be more than happy to be of assistance. Again, welcome to the family and the body of Christ.